Okay, welcome back YouTube and Twitch. I've just swapped you over to being
I've
able
not
to
seen the
view
wilderness like this before.
Path of Exile.
There'll be some dark days ahead.
Obviously, the first thing we need to do is we need to get off the beach. We are presented with a bow. Could make it a little bit easy to get off the beach. You know, those iron gauntlets. Maybe not the best for the long run, but for just a little bit of armor, are not gonna hurt. In the end, we will have to forego gauntlets, but that's level 32. That's a long way off. And on the starting beach, it's often worth just running past everything, at least to begin. Because killing Hillock as sort of part of the tutorial will always level you to level 2. So even if you wanted to maximize getting XP off of guys in the zone, or maximize loot from the zone, you're probably better off running over here, killing Hillock, and then going back to kill everything. In practice, most people will hold off trying to farm stuff until they get out into some of the later zones. I think that was all that was vaguely useful. Maybe the hat. Maybe the hat. 6% lightning resist. Nothing to sneeze at.
Farewell.
So I'm going ahead and prep some stuff here. So we can't use the quill rain until 5. I can possibly use that ring earlier. You're 5. We'll pick up all our stuff. We'll be using vaguely. 56 would be too far out. I don't think
Hello.
You sell me what I'm thinking about yet. You already sell caustic arrow. There you do. Okay. I saw the caustic arrow earlier. Okay.
God hasn't.
Oh, there's an eye.
Let me get leveling. So caustic arrow is sort of like a spell. Bow skill. So it does damage based on the level of the skill gem. Pretty reliable damage based on the level of the skill gem. So as a side effect, you don't necessarily need to be all that skilled in using it from a skill tree standpoint to get fairly good use out of it. Which is why I'm going to use it as the leveling skill. If I was using a different character base, I might do something like splitting skill, or splitting steel. But then that would be a little bit more weapon dependent. Because this build is going to be using a lot of cluster gems. I am going to go ahead and run the optional zone in Act 1 because I want the respec points at some point. I suspect I'm going to want those respec points. If you didn't need those respec points, you'd probably skip it. I think this is the one of the very few monsters in the campaign that will try to aim for where you're going instead of where you are. Character's still level 2, but we got the caustic arrow leveled up once, so it'll do a little bit more damage. Flats.
The worms will have to wait a bit longer for this meal.
It's not necessarily all that exciting for leveling. Be a little bit careful not to get stun-locked by these guys, if I don't want to die. This is the normal tri league, so it's not necessarily end of the world if I die. It's just kind of disappointing. I should be able to get through this content without dying. Not worth the time to kill the guy. I suppose in the end it would have been better not to run into him. But we did. Kill them, so I'm gonna finish the job. Almost getting stun locked there.
Pain brings strength. That's nature for you.
Flasks. Now, have the capacity to grid my bow. This is a side area that you wouldn't normally go in unless you want respec points. Just because I haven't gone and gotten the Quicksilver Flask, if one of the enemies goes and does a good job of hiding it, it's a pain to find them. Zone boss. It's the main guy we've come here to kill. One advantage of Caustic Arrow is, in theory, it does caustic damage, it does chaos damage, which just penetrates his shield if he's got any up. Clearing the zone to get those respec points. To talk about here, other than I'm just sort of running around and twanging people with the bow. Why the Chaos damage over time effect. Four left, okay. There's all four. There we go. We just need to run to the transition to the next zone. Slot the quest items we picked up in the submerged passage. I'll quickly take the portal back to town. To go pick up the Quicksilver Flask so we can run a bit faster. That poison might be interesting.
Farewell.
So. Fine wood.
Picked up the caustic arrow that we get as a reward, but I've already bought one, so I don't need it. Sniper's mark. Might be worth grabbing for the moat. Ash.
Necromancer.
That was the respect points.
Farewell.
There we
God hasn't abandoned us.
Just realizing that I did not pull out earlier Gold Rim. Not Water Gold Rim. Yeah, Gold Rim will be a decent replacement. Got some generic boots. Better generic boots? Maybe. Going to that movement speed and can't be frozen? Yes. Now, to getting through the rest of Act 1.
I'm not up for that.
This side of the bridge first, so we can get that skill point. must be getting closer. I'm getting attacked by the crab. Not much going on here, other than I'm just sort of shooting him every once in a while to apply the chaos damage over time effect. The brigadine's probably not useful, but don't know until we test it. Better than nothing at 8. We're not 8 yet. Immunity Knight. I should probably be... oh. Way overcapped. Plenty of cold resist. Also known as I probably have enough cold resist to deal with Mervale already. Iron hat. No, the iron hat's gonna be better than my current hat. guess we're just going to zoom through these zones. Because of the raw power of caustic arrow, I am killing a lot more than I probably need to be to get through the zones. And again, I've basically done absolutely nothing to make caustic arrow any better than what it is default, out of the box by itself. Quill Rain is letting me have a slightly higher shoot speed, projectile launching speed, attack speed, or whatever you want to call it. But if anything, I think it's actually reducing the damage I'm doing. It's not necessarily upping the damage I'm doing. This means I can spend most of the time moving and less of the time shooting.
There's no justice in a place like this. Only misery.
Back to town, we're gonna pick up that one skill point that we generated earlier.
You meant it.
Thank you.
Farewell.
Stop clicking when it's on the floor, that's what I'm gonna get. Okay, and then using. Oops. There we go. I don't need two of those targeted. Wind ventilation. Probably not a good use of it, but we'll do that one. Yeah, well, we already have the hit points and resistance for what I want for the act, so at this point it's just killing the bosses to get through the act, while not getting behind in the levels by skipping too many enemies. Swap from caustic arrow to caustic rain after I beat Brutus. I think Caustic Rain scales a little bit better raw damage wise with attack speed. What I'm currently using. There it is. I'd have been a little more keen with checking the map, but I could avoid going the wrong way there.
Quite sure of yourself, aren't you, Huntress? The Warden enjoys the taste of...
Got Piety taunting us like she does every time we come here. Slightly different taunt based on what your base character is, but taunting you nonetheless. This fight against Bruce might be a little slow because I'm not as leveled as I might otherwise be. I'm only level 9 going up against Bruce at level 9. With a gem that does pretty heavily scale with character level. just like this. Slowly grind down with poison. Brutus.
I've done for you what I would do for any wounded animal, Brutus.
I'm not on that life right now. More than the cold, at least. On we go. That's Brutus. Next item I have is 11. philosophers in theory should have good XP.
Life and death live side by 11. Side. This is a strange.
That'll get to be my next item. It's not that much improvement, I think, the next item, but it's an item. It'll do something. Looking around for the transition zone into the area with the thing I need for the quest. There's the door. Might need to take a little bit of time to level. A little too hard. Flame. Very, as a unique, this person should get a decent amount of XP. I'll quickly take them down. So as I brought up in sort of the prospective part of this video, if you're watching on Twitch, or if you're watching on YouTube in the previous video in the series, this is going to be a holopoint, or holopalm technique build, which is a version of an unarmed build. But that doesn't really come online until the build gets to like 32. So, for the moment, I'm just leveling with caustic arrow, just to have a skill that's sort of build agnostic to level with. Sure, kill Freight Race here. This will be the last time back to town. Well, back to Act 1 town. And then we'll finish the run of Act 1. Actually wearing? No. No. I already did that song before. Back blind eyes watch. Passive skill effect.
Stay sharp out there.
Note, if you're looking to the build as it is right now is definitely not the optimal way to build Caustic Air if you're planning on keeping it long run. But Caustic Air is just a reasonably strong skill, and as a side effect, you can kind of do what you want with it early on, as far as the tree is concerned. Another reward. Does that reward actually give me something? You're gonna actually give me something.
If you must.
Yes. Toxic rain. Let's swap to toxic rain. Or at least swap our chance to poison.
Take care.
So if memory serves, toxic rain scales a little bit better with the attack speed that Quill Rain is giving me. Feels like some serious damage. I'm level 12 in the level 12 area. Okay. Maybe not the best idea to be running around with a bleed on you, but, you know. Oh, did I really go the wrong way? I've gone real the wrong way. Okay. Use these quicksilvers. There's a reason I picked them up. like it's a dead end. I guess it is.
I'm not up to that just yet.
Taking too many wrong turns? This way. No, we got the Val side zone in here screwing up the map. It's one of the top right corners where Vale's door is. Phase 1 done. Remember how long that took on the Facebreaker build. You can already see how powerful Reign of Chaos is. It's basically what our leveling skill is going to be for shooting the bigger enemies going forward. Oscar.
Your love for a man, that's what did this to you, Mervail.
Boots might be usable. Probably aren't. Yeah. And with that, we've technically finished Act 2, or Act 1, but we'll quickly take the character to the town zone, so teleport. That's gonna be the end of the video. Hope you're all having a good time. Catch you all next time. This is where we're gonna go ahead and end the YouTube video and end the stream for a bit. Hope you all have been having a good time. This presumably will continue. We'll probably get to Hollow Point or Hollow Palm, probably not the end of next act, but we're now in Act 2, but not during Act 2, but probably during Act 3 we'll get to the point where we actually start using Hollow Palm. So catch you then.